I want to make stuff that matters, stuff that touches people, stuff that gets them excited, that gets them angry, that gets them sad. I don't care what it makes them feel. I want to make them feel something. I want to make them inspired. I want to inform them. I want to inspire them. I want to motivate them, because art fucking makes art. I know I haven't been posting on this YouTube channel for a long time, and that is because I've been busy posting daily on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube Shorts, short content for my new brand called Zoom Out. I guess I can make a lot of excuses, but the truth is I'm just kind of lazy, but also consumed by the saturated market that is social media. I can say what I want. Like, I wanted to make this big entrance with a video about procrastination that I ended up procrastinating a lot. And the whole idea behind that video was that you only need one video to come back in the rhythm of making videos for a certain platform. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm just talking to a camera. I want to talk about the state of the internet, because I feel super strong about it right now, and I just want to share my opinion because I feel like it's important. So that's what we're doing today. I was watching this video by Jack Conte called The Death of the Follower. He basically says everything that I'm going to say in this video, but better, because he's a super good public speaker. Jack Conte is the CEO and founder of Patreon and a host on one of my favorite YouTube channels called Digital Spaghetti. So the link of that video will be in the description. Definitely go watch that. He tells everything way better than me, but I still want to make this video because I think it's important to talk about. Social media, or the internet, it was built as this thing to connect people from around the world, which at that time was and still is insane. Like, people forget how insane it is that, for example, right now I am filming this video on my exchange in Toronto, and I'm gonna upload this video to YouTube, and all of my friends might see it across the Atlantic Ocean. What the f? It's a way to reach a lot of people that might like the stuff that I make, simply because of the fact that they might not live in your town or your village of 100 people. Because that's where I grew up. I grew up in a village in the south of France with 100 inhabitants filled with old people. And so, of course, that's not my freaking target audience. So the internet was all of a sudden my gateway to the world, which is huge and insane. I remember in 2020, I just started DMing people that had the same interests as me and followed the same accounts as me, because I was bored like everyone. But do you know how insane that is? Like, the chance that I would have met or talked to those people in another lifetime had been next to zero. But have you noticed that when I said that when I upload this video, my friends might see it? Yeah. Well, that's because although a lot of my friends are subscribed to my YouTube channel, they have to have their YouTube notifications on and they have to click the little bell in order to stay in touch with me and my videos. Jack explains this in a very logical way. There are three ways that someone might see something that I make on the internet, or let's take YouTube as an example. Number one is reach. People who don't know me, they've never seen me, but they see something I make. They might like it, they might not, I don't care. They have seen my shit. The second level are followers. Followers are people that came across my stuff and said, hey, you know what? I like this guy. I want to stay in touch with what he makes and I want to follow him. And the third level is the true fan. That is someone who is going to buy merch that I don't have, but it's someone that really feels a connection between them and me. Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, YouTube, kind of as well. They are killing the follower because they're all up here in reach. And that's great because I want to reach a lot of people. But if they actually decide that they like the shit I make, it's becoming harder and harder for me to reach those people who are so important. All of that because of this one thing that Facebook came up with: ranking. They came up with a system that puts the algorithm in charge of what post comes on top and what becomes on the bottom of someone's feed based on whether it's entertaining enough or not. And it worked, you know? People spend more and more time on their platform. And so Facebook made a shit ton of money. They became stupidly rich because of this. And because of that, everyone started doing it. All because of fucking money. I get it. You have to pay your bills and like the world revolves around money. But I happened to study creative business. And what I learned is that for any brand ever, you start with three things: a name, a mission, and a vision. Your name is obvious. It's your brand name. Your mission is a mission that you're trying to accomplish. Like, it's a goal. And number three is a vision. It's the vision of the world that they're trying to participate in. And all of these, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, whatever, Facebook, their mission has come down to making a shit ton of money with this. And they have forgotten creators. And what does that mean? It means that this free distribution platform, I have to make videos according to retention. I am doing it for the platform, for them to make money, because I'm incentivized to make a video that's more entertaining so that people stay on the platform longer and so that Instagram or YouTube or whatever make more money. Which are criteria that I don't know what they are or have control over or agree with. By making this video, I want to be a part of the people that make a change to this. And I'm not saying that I'm gonna start a war against social media platforms because they're giants, but... And by the way, I'm going to continue making daily videos on Instagram because not only, of course, do I feed the algorithm, but it also creatively fulfills me. So it's important. But I want to make stuff that matters. Just like Jack said, I'm stealing this from him, but it doesn't matter because I totally agree. I want to make stuff that matters. Stuff that touches people. Stuff that gets them excited, that gets them angry, that gets them sad. I don't care what it makes them feel. I want to make them feel something. I want to make them inspired. I want to inform them. I want to inspire them. I want to motivate them because art fucking makes art. If I make something and people feel something, then they're gonna make something and make other people feel something. And that's awesome. And the internet is a platform where that's possible. But they're taking away this crucial thing that is being able to reach people that like your stuff. And that's why the internet is so mind-bogglingly awesome. I can make something and inspire someone on the other side of the freaking world. I want to build deep connections. I want to build community. And I want to get to know these people that like my stuff. So if you agree with anything that I said, if there's even anyone watching at this point of the video, because my retention is going to be shit, I want you to know with my stuff that you are not alone. That's what I'm trying to make with this video, because it's important. You are not alone. If you agree with what I said, just make the same video. Like, I want to unite the people that think like this, and I want to make these platforms for the artist again. So zoom out, because you're not alone. Peace.